Hello and welcome to Enots Engineering. I'm Alan. Today we'll be making a part on the CNC machine. It's the plate that tells you what angle you've set the table to on the tool and cutter grinder. So we'll go through the stages, how we set up the program and how we made it on the machine. It's made out of a car number plate, so let's see how we did it. Use the pointer to mark the position on the back of the knob of the two holes. Drill two holes about 3mm diameter and then make two brass rivets and rivet the pointer on the back of the knob. I'll show you how I made the angle plate with the degrees. How I transferred it from a drawing into a CNC program. Now, first of all, what I've got on here, the red line represents the side of my tool and cutter grinder, which is steel pressing. So I've drawn that out first. Then the green lines are the part I'm going to make. Moving on the green area, this is a drawing of the part, the finished part, and you can see it's got numbers around there, the angle and the degrees all marked out. So the way I do this is to draw what you need straight onto this program, which is called Kanban, so that you can transfer that into a CNC program which can be loaded into the CNC machine and cut the part exactly the same. So first of all, we've got a hole. Now on this side, on the left hand side, you can see the hole diameter and the hole position in X and Y, which you can alter. So I can control exactly where that hole will be. Same on this side, another hole. Move it down. I did a CNC program to cut the finger out. Of course, once you've got that, you can overlay the finger on the part, get the positioning right, the radiuses of these lines correct, then all you need to do is mark the angles out. Now I did the angles by here, put some paper on the side panel, put the finger at a zero position, and then tilting the table 2 degrees a time and marking out the angles. I then transferred that, once I know the distance between each 2 degree angle, I can step it round on here, put the lines in, mark it out. Once I've got the drawing done, I can then transfer the drawing into a CNC program. And the way you do that is, if you look on this side, these are all the arcs and the lines. So I can select an arc or a line, they're all separate items to be cut. So on the machining, come down here, this is the first line the machine will do this, and you can select here the speeds, the feed, the depth, type of cutter. So basically you select each line, and then once you select what sort of shape, in other words, these are all engraving. So when I select engraving, it'll come up on this side and you build up a list of engraving, then the two holes and then the outside profile. Now on the outside profile, if you cut this out without the holding tabs, which is these squares, what will happen is when you come to the near the cutting through, this middle bit will come loose. You could wrap around your cutter or fly over the workshop. But by putting a holding tab in, which are these, this bit is not machined here. So when, as the cutter comes round, it will lift up, go across the top and go back down to leave this part of the material still attached. So on the component, you've got six areas where the metal piece that you want is still attached to the original piece of metal, so it's not loose. Then all you do is, when you finish your machining, snip out these bits, file the edges up, and the part's finished. But once it's done as a drawing, and you've converted it into different operations, you then go into machining, produce G codes, and then the computer will produce the code. Now, to find out whether that code is okay, this is telling me now, this is where the cutter's going to cut on the outside, so you know it's in the right area. As these are engravings, it's only going to touch the surface, so it's not cutting through. The two holes show me that the cutter's going to cut on the inside of the marked area. So in other words, if that was a 5mm hole and I had a 3mm cutter, I could cut it either on the outside of the marked hole or on the inside. And obviously the difference would be the one would be bigger than the other because of the cutter diameter. So you just check that everything's okay there. And then another program that's linked into this is Cut Viewer. So I then just click onto that. It pulls the program into Cut Viewer. Press run. This is the actual machining being run, simulated on the program. And I can zoom in on that because it's quite a distance away. And then as you get closer, you can see the degrees, the bits here where the tabs are, where it's not cut through. Look at this one in 3D. You can actually move the part round to see what it looks like. At the thickness of the work, make sure it's okay. It will actually tell you if you've got fixtures fitted, it will tell you if you're going to hit the fixtures. So that's how I produce my program. And on the left here, you can see the actual program. Lines of code for the CNC machine. Then all I do is save that onto a memory stick and load it into the Mark III on the CNC machine. The program's been loaded into the CNC machine, so we'll start the machine up and cut the part. We'll be right back.
to adjust the angle and slacken the nut off on the other side, hold this, turn it to whatever angle you need to set it to, just lock it.
Well, thanks for watching. I hope you've enjoyed it, and we'll see you next time on Enots Engineering.